Well, good morning, everyone. Welcome aboard Flying with Mike. Today's flight is out of Warsaw, Poland. And as you can see on the ramp, we're going to be taking the Airbus 320 for a little trip up to St. Petersburg, Russia. I'm sure the airline is probably not the one out of Poland that would take us up there, Air Berlin, but they're close enough, so I figured since it's in the package that comes down with Flight Factor, we'll give it a run instead of the easy jet that you saw in the promo. But anyway, like I said, we are here, Warsaw. We are flying X plane. I have not come up on VATSIM yet. That is going to happen here in a few minutes. We're at stand 13 on the default scenery, in case you all want to join in. Want to say, Shayogun, welcome aboard. Thanks for chatting in the chat room there during the intro. Glad to meet you as well. And as I said in my reply, I will try to do my best here to fly the bus correctly. I have really hardly anything but a checklist to go with and a lot of Boeing knowledge achieved through flying the 747 here on the sim with PMDG. But yeah, we'll do the best we can. I'm taking another Airbus pilot out there. He also streams, I can't remember, V1 simulation maybe. I've got so many I follow, I can't remember them all, but he did a big series on how to fly the flight factor. So hopefully what I present is accurate. Feel free to check me. I'm not at all that familiar with Airbuses, even after the half a dozen to a dozen flights I've flown in it now. So, but I really like the plane from Flight Factor. Really cool. But as you can see, sitting on the stand here, we got the chocks in, external power hooked up, and on the other side of the aircraft here, let me kind of speed that along. Fuel trucks connected, and the loaders are up into the plane. I don't have the animation for the jetways set up, mainly because I think the documentation is kind of wishy-washy, if you will. I don't even, if not non-existent, it doesn't tell me where to put it. So, I mean, I've got some ideas where to put it, but I don't think it's where it's supposed to go in a computer. It would be somewhere else outside the computer. That's another story for another day, and a very poor taste in a possible joke that I was trying to make that kind of, yeah. But anyway, Luke, SK, welcome aboard. It's been a while since we've seen it. We're doing great. And yourself? At the same time, we're going to go ahead and get up into cockpit so we can get rid of that little humming noise in the background. I believe that was our generator running external, but not 100% sure. So here we are, folks, up in the cockpit. Again, it's Warsaw to St. Petersburg. Hang on a second here. I'm going to pull up something here. I hate that when I lose my train of thought. Doggone it. Well, we'll go this route. Okay, we're going to go ahead and it's a trip that's going to take us 638 miles and approximately 2 hours to fly. Now, like I said, we are going to do this on VATSIM. I haven't put the flight plan into VATSIM yet, so that's why I'm not on VATSIM yet. But I did think about running POSCON, but I know with Europe at this time of the day, those of you in Europe would maybe like to tag along. I mean, tons of people fly this hour of the day. Obviously, it's your prime time evening time when you have time to fly. Wow, too much time there. There I go again. So moving on. So let's get into doing the preliminary cockpit check here so we can get this show on the road and up to St. Petersburg. Okay, we're cold and dark, and the EFP over here on the pilot side, also one opposite on the co-pilot side, is set up. You can see we've already got the generator up and connected, not connected into the plane. We're completely cold and dark on the plane. The chocks are installed. I've got the fuel truck. You saw that out there. The gate's hooked up. We haven't put the passengers or any of that in. Same with the fuel as the cargo as well. The loaders are in place to do their business. actually, we can do a lot of this stuff right from here. Hopefully, this is fairly decent on visual for you. Kind of bring it in a little. No! Oh, I hate when it does this. Oh, good, it stopped. Would you stop it? You know, I really hate this thing. Okay, we're going to try this again, folks. Ugh, Flight Factor does this to me all the time. I hate it. Would you cut it out? If I have any complaints about Flight, this is it. Okay, I'm just going to ease it on down this way. Sorry, folks. Ah, you would. You know, something I thought was going to be so easy always turns into being so hard. Hopefully you all can read that, because that's as much as I'm going to do. Sorry. Alrighty, what a way to start the stream off today. But anyway, you can kind of get an idea of what we're doing here. Like I said, it's 638 air miles. We're going to be flying at 37,000 feet. There's our cost index for the day, 60. And fuel, 8,283 kilograms. So we'll get all of that loaded up here shortly. Our flight plan was on the opening screen, but it's right here as well. And I believe in the chat room. If not, we'll put it out there again, just in case. All right. So continuing down, here's our scheduled time of 2 hours, estimating 2 hours, 14 minutes. We are going to put 176 people on board, 300 kilograms of cargo, bringing us up to about 15.1 on that number. So there you go with the basic idea of what we're going to fly with today. So let me get back to here and get off this crazy screen. Okay. All right. So we're going to go over and do that preliminary cockpit check now. Starts down here at the base of your pedestal and works up to the overhead panel, and then we'll power up and start setting up the aircraft. So the first thing I want to look at is the parking brake. Make sure it's engaged, and you'll know it is. The top of it that looks like an arrow will point to 3 o'clock. Coming up further, put your spoilers down, because mine always seem to come in here at 50%. No idea why. Flaps need to be at zero. Your start lever, hang on, let me do a little better justice here, needs to be pointing 12 o'clock or on the norm. And then your two start switches next to it, off. Now, I also look at the radar, make sure it's in the off position. Most of this doesn't work, but your tilt, your mode, and your gain all work. Only the one or two work on the switches, unless there's something out there that I'm not aware of that I could get in here to make work. Okay, from there, let me get back to where we started. So we left off at the radar. Now you're up to the throttles. Make sure they move, because you really, if you want to go and, you know, go at the speed we normally do it, around 460 on the true airspeed, yeah, you're going to have to be able to give it some juice. All right, pushing up a little further. We're going to make sure the landing gear lever is down. Now, how you can tell this plane is completely cold and dark, even though the external power is hooked up, your landing gear lights are off. When we come up with both the batteries, or one of the batteries, I believe, they'll light up along with the standby ADI here. Pushing up now, we're on the overhead panel. Just make sure your wipers are turned off. And that, folks, concludes the cockpit preparation checks. So it's time to power up, and I'm just going to go up to the overhead panel to make it eat. Well, it's not really that easy. Hang on. You know, I just realized. All right, so let's go up here. Here's your lighting section, air conditioning and pressurization, and your electrical panel. On the electrical panel, next to your BAT1, BAT2 displays, those are your, I believe, voltages right now. If you were to click, as you can tell right now, it's cold and dark. There's nothing lit up on the panel, nothing on the mid panel. Push battery 1. We're going to get the off indication. And what I just heard concerns me. I forgot to hook up my headphones for the music, and I'm scared. Hello, hello. I'm a little confused there, Shagun. Hang on a second. PWS. What's the PWS? And hello, DJ. Welcome aboard. Thank you for joining in. Hang on a second here. So we've got the first battery on. If we come down, let's get the second battery. I thought that would do it. I know the second one will. And now you'll see those three green lights right here. Okay, moving on, we just need to put the external power on, and that lights up the whole cockpit up here. And yeah, we've, hang on a second. I want to make sure something's going on. Because all of a sudden, all I hear is my airplane and my speakers. And that usually doesn't happen. So bear with me a second.
When you have time to fly. Wow, too much time there. There I go again. So moving on. So let's get into the preliminary cockpit check here. So how did that lights up the whole cockpit up here?
Hang on just a second, folks. I'm checking the audio here. All right. Sorry about that, folks. I just realized I was muting myself. I love when I do stupid things like that. But anyway, I'm just going through here real quick and getting things back up and running. The PWS switch, yeah, I now know where you're talking. I don't know why mine doesn't work. All right, so we got these guys going. See if my charts will come back up. Yay! No, I didn't say that way. You're supposed to be dark. There we go. Okay. Oh, come on, mouse. Now, don't you start acting up. All right, so real quick, let's get back. Let me do a quick look here since we stopped everything. Okay, we're 3 o'clock. Spoilers all the way up. 0. 12 o'clock, norm, off and off. Yeah, it doesn't work for me. And this one would work, but I'm going to keep it right in the center. And these three work. Okay, so back to this one. Okay, you're working. Landing gear's down. And the two wiper switches are off. Okay, so we're going to get back to where we were. The battery switch is on. Number two is on. Bringing up most of the fault lights, but not all of them. Okay. There we go. Now the sounds are right. Oh. Now I'm going to ask Shayogin, what does the PWS do? I know somebody told me once, but I can't ever find what it was. And I'm going to just move on to getting my overhead lights set up. That's a 12. Set. Those are set. Make these as bright as they can be. Okay. Folks, I do apologize for the really horrible start to this today. Ugh. Okay. Floods down here are set. Okay, so we've got the aircraft powered up, prepared, cockpit-wise, lighting, and, we've done our preliminary check, so let's load the aircraft using the EFB right here. And what I'm also going to do, sometimes really do stink. It's the wind shear. Oh, to detect wind shear. Okay. Predictive wind shear system. Okay. Now that doesn't sound familiar, so maybe my source was a little shady. Who knows? Like I said, I heard it once, but I don't even know if he said what it meant. Alright, so. Let's push this in a way we can utilize both at the same time. Okay, so I've got Sim Toolkit up. We're going to move over to packs first. And for this flight, the loadout sheet says 176. So we're just going to plug that in right here. 176. set. And as you can see, there's only about 4 seats available, as there should be cargo. Now the loadout sheet here does not show your cargo. So what we do is we go to the flight plan, double check. Set that as well. Finally, we're going to go ahead and load our fuel, which will be right here, 8283. Set. And it's going to preset all the different areas you need it at. Okay, and that's set. Look at our perf data real quick. Looks like everything's in the arc like it should be. Zero fuel weight. Does that add up correctly? 926, 826, 824. I think it added on an extra kilogram. It sure did, which is fine. That keeps us in the limits. We're good there. And our zero fuel is 28.8. Okay, I had something I needed to write there. Okay, so we are now loaded, and I'm going to go ahead and move these two and remove the fuel truck. I'll leave the quote door open and simulating as all in the center. That the jetway's hooked up is our emergency egress. Alright, so from here, let's press on and get that APU started and get this overhead panel set up so we can do the McDo. Okay, so we're going to go up here. Basically, the APU check starts with a fire check, so we're going to watch here. Unfortunately, I can't keep the test button pushed. There it is. Tried something different today. Okay, we got our warning and our warning. Shouldn't be anything down here. Okay. Finally, after so many attempts to get that to stay on, I finally figured out the combo. I had to actually put a finger on my nose, point the other one towards Jupiter, and then push the button and right-click over. Just kidding. Basically, I left-clicked and then right-clicked while it was pushed down. Finally got that thing going. I've been wanting to do the test properly. Okay, so we've done the fire check. Next up, we're going to turn the master switch on. The APU is where the lights and the seatbelts are. It's right in the middle. It's the top switch right under APU. Down here. And what we're watching for is flap open. Once that comes on, we'll then click it into start. Just doing some checks right now and making sure the flap is open. There it is. Next up, start. And then we can just watch it spool up. When it hits 100%, we're going to see available, and we should see numbers in the jet. Now, I'm not seeing bleed numbers. I don't know if, again, I've got something to update here or need to update it, but here it comes. Okay, there's the gen. You can see now it's pushing voltage. It says available. So what we're going to do is come back to the overhead. We're going to click APU, not that one yet, that one, the bleed, and check some. Actually, still not seeing what the bleed is for sure. All right, well, that's okay. And we can see our doors open. Okay. Well, the APU is running. Now, the checklist says I can turn the external power off and the ground power off. I work at an airport in public safety here in the States, Mid-America Airport. Might have seen them. The Boeing company has been out there for the last several months testing the unmanned drone that refuels Navy aircraft. They made history last week in refueling an aircraft in flight, first unmanned drone refueling of a fighter. So you may see it on the news. But I just saw it released by the Boeing company. I've been told not to talk till I saw that. So now they have, I'm talking. So, but anyway, we get Allegiant into the airport. They're all Airbuses. They seem to keep the cord hooked up until they're pretty close to pushing back. So I'm going to kind of follow their lead. I'm not a pilot. First off, I'm not a commercial pilot. I do have a private pilot's license. Just need to get recurrent. I haven't flown since 1986. But just need to get recurrent and I can fly Cessnas, Pipers, and those. I really don't think they'd let me fly Airbuses. I would sure love to, but I don't think it'd be pretty. Maybe it would. Who knows? They seem to be a pretty easy plane on the sim. I don't know in the real world if they're that easy. So, I digress. Let's get on up to the cockpit overhead panel and let's get this bird set to go. Now, the checklist I have that I downloaded, it's a flight factor A320 checklist from xplane.org. So, it could be wrong. I've kind of added some stuff in because I understand flows go upward now instead of downward like the Boeings I'm used to. So we flow up this one, we flow up this one, and we flow up this one. And they skip over some things like crew supply. I turned that on. Here's your calls to the back. These I know will not clear until this is aligned. And then we're going to go nav. We're going to get aligned and we're waiting for on battery. That'll let us know that the system will work. The navigation, inertial navigation, will stay good. And there was on bat if we lose the engine generators. Okay, next one is over here. It'll say align and then an on bat. Okay, there's the on bat. And let's do number three. And perfect. There we go. There's a few more things as we look up toward up the panel here. I have no idea what this refuel panel is all about. I can't seem to find a good manual to give me an idea. Or any of these over here. I do know these. It's a lot of circuit numbers. So let's come back down here. So went too far. So back down to the bottom. We're going to do the lights now. Aircraft exterior lights. Nothing on the bottom row. We'll start here with the strobes to auto. I know in the US we probably keep them off or we keep them auto until we go onto the runway and kick them on. Either way, they're going to come on when the aircraft leaves the ground. Next, we're going to come over. Well, that's funny how the checklist forgets. Nav lights. Last flight I flew on nav 1, we're going to do nav 2 this time. Seatbelts on, smoking on, and too far, sorry, come down. Arm the emergency lights. Okay, next up we come up to this area here. Make sure your landing elevation is set to auto. Okay. As we come up, I'm just looking for any faults. When I do, okay, these are for the generators. The engines aren't running. That's kind of a clue. And stand by. I've got someone at the door. wife took it. Okay. Didn't know where she went. All right, so as we watch, these faults are for the engines. The generators aren't on yet. I mean, the engines aren't on to turn the generators on. Fuel pumps we can turn off. And we'll do our fire checks. Hang on, I'm going to switch back to my other camera, that one, to do my engine fire check. See if what I just learned works. It does. Cut that out. Oh, you stopped it. Okay. What the heck is going on here? All right. Geez, that was really bizarre. Let's try that again. If it does that again, we won't do that ever again. Okay. All right, so we got the fire alarm. There's that warning. That warning. If you're not sure what I'm pointing at, just wait. Let's try one last time. I think it's because I clicked. So, I'm not going to be able to click in, but you can see the engine fire there. Also shows fire down here. Yep, that's what it is. So, I can't click after I do that. Okay. We'll do the same thing for this one. Okay, that one's on. Got the warning lights there, warning light there, and the warning light there. And they're both clear. Boy, what a day. Hopefully you don't have that hard of a time, Shabgun, with this. Oh, man, that's giving me some fun there. All right, and coming up this side, we're going to turn these two, which are called the cargo heats, hot air, and alternate isolation valve, and we're going to just set it to 12 o'clock there, and then work our way up, no faults, and we're on VHF3. This is the third VHF, just want to make sure it's lit up on that one. All right, coming down to the main panel, I got to speed things up here. Way too long. And I see I was being silly and left center. Yep, it's definitely a day. Okay, so we're on the middle panel. Main panel, we're going to make sure the nose steer, anti-skid and nose wheel steering is turned on. My checklist here, I get a good chuckle out of every time it calls these FMCs instead of the McDo's. It might be in the real world, but either McDo's in the Airbus, FMC, and the Boeings. Likewise, they flip things around in the 767 to where it actually says McDo on the FMCs and FMC in the checklist. So it's just kind of funny with flight vector. All right, so both of them are on, which is good. And radio 1, we're going to set to 122.800. And I'm just going to set if we were on POSCON, just because I like the frequency, 12345. Okay, and then over here. Set another Unicom channel. Let's do that one. Okay, now, one thing, folks, that I want to let you know about with the flight deck. In order to communicate with the air traffic control, aside from being connected to the client, make sure the microphone is turned on. In this case, we're using VHF-1, so you want to make sure that's turned on so you'll be able to transmit. POSCON, definitely. In VATSIM, I turned it on anyway just to be safe. And then down to the TCAS, we want to, since we're not on right now, we don't have any squawks, we're just going to put 2,000 in here. Now, one thing I've learned with VATSIM, as long as you're in, standby, or here, let me see if I can zoom in here. Let's come down. Okay. Okay, right now we're in standby and auto up here. Now, if I turn this over to on, when I get the V-Pilot up, you'll see the mode C indication, those of you familiar with that. So as long as I keep it in auto, let me just do this so I can let you see. V-Pilot or X-Pilot, where are you? And again, please be mindful, I'm not online yet. So let's fade that over. Okay, so you should be seeing the V-Pilot. Right now it's showing standby. See how it says connect, standby? When I switch over to on, now you see mode C. I ran into a trouble about 3 flights ago with this coming out of an airport. And just offline, online, without a controller, I figured it out. So that's what you need to do. And I'm going to go back to my normal setting here. For now, get rid of X-Pilot. Just a little, trying to, you know, give some data there to you. So that, folks, wraps up the basic cockpit preparation for the flight from here, Warsaw, to St. Petersburg. All that's left is to get the McDude fired up. Now, to do this, I want to bring both up here real quick. Now, once you get away from this screen, if you ever need to come back to it, and basically you're seeing your engine, your AERNAC date, which, by the way, what is today, the 7th? Got about 10 days to that date. We'll let you know what you're running currently with your flight factor. Okay, to get back to here, you would just click data and aircraft status. Right back on it. We're going to go ahead and use McDude 1 over here. It's the captain's side. And what we're going to do is go to the INT. INIT. We're going to put it in EPWA/ULLI. We don't have a flight plan out there. I'll type it in real quick. And we're going to be flying under MAC 0572. And our cost index is 60, 73 and 76. There we go. And 37, I believe, is our altitude today. Yep, 37. And I do not know the flight level temperature, so we're just going to go with default on that. We're going to go ahead and click wind request. Fills it in for me. Back, and we're going to do the IRS initialization, and we're going to align on the reference, and we're going to confirm it. And it's going to start doing its magic of aligning up where we're at stand wise and all of that. So we go back. Now where my checklist says to set up the weights and the performance page, and it could just be me and my Boeing ideas, I put the flight plan in first, then the aircraft performance. Hopefully, I'm really not out of, you know, that is what they're saying here is correct. I don't know. But I go to F plan. So, today's flight. Let me put that in here real quick. One more time for y'all. And it also covers me. It's going to do that. Hang on a second. I'm just restarting some toolkit. I knew it's because I reset the setup, so. What is it? Everything that could go wrong is going wrong right now for me? Yeah, you know, it's. Hopefully, as I put, if you all saw it at the very beginning of the chat, hopefully, we're not going to have a repeat of our flight last time. Where it actually OBS crashed. And we had to restart everything. So update, fly, there we go. Now let's try that. There we go. Okay, so that'll help make it easier for you all. You can see our departure is going to be runway 33. AMS 5 kilo. I don't know, there's no transition on this. Insert. And now to put it in. So from BAM, BAM's out. Back. First off, GPS primary means we're aligned. Clear that off. And I'll clear it off over this one. There. Now, if I could keep my nav display looking like that through the whole flight, I would be so happy. But I end up seeing TA down here the most of the flight, and I don't know what causes that. But all right, so let's press on. That's down the road when we get into the air. We've got to get to that point first. Okay, so we're using the up button to scroll up to our BAM zone. We're going to click the line select next to it, then airways. And we're going to put in Z182. And then for 2, ASL. To the flight plan. Okay, next up, airway. Yes, okay. Same thing, airways. It says 460. Okay, and that one goes to XP11. I know once you get used, you get thousands of hours in this plane, it's like second nature. So, but it just seems so much easier on the phone. G-I-T-I-L. Last one, November 7th, 43. To Colette. K-L-L-T. And the reason I pause is I make sure I spell things right. Hopefully it will pick up if I did. Okay, so now we've got a discontinuity because there's the arrival. All I'm going to put in for now is the cold one whiskey. Because we may, I don't know St. Petersburg yet, which side's the best for us to come in on. So 10 rights what SimBrief gave us. But I've had SimBrief give me a 3,000 foot runway to land on before. And I want to say I was flying a 747 or a 777. Not the best runway to choose. And it wasn't meters. Before you guys in Europe yell at me, that was in meters. No, it wasn't. It was feet. So, arrival? Oh, I have to put the runway in. All right, so let me pull that up quickly. Okay, so they're both the same. 10 right's the one closest to us, okay. And 10 right is there. So 10 right would be the better one because we're closer to the entrance to it. Okay, so we'll go 10 right. I said that once, going into Innsbruck. Oh, there was a big difference here. Got that in. What I'm going to do real quick here is do a check to make sure I don't see any big discrepancies. To do that, we'll switch to plan, and we're going to walk our way through this thing by clicking the up arrow. Here's where the airplane is. We're set at arc and 20. So click, kind of walk ourselves through. Also looking for flight discontinuities. So far so good, everything's looking good. Okay, we're coming up to Colette, which is our start to our SID or star, sorry, got it backwards again. To DICA and right onto arc image, and everything looks good. So what I'm going to do is turn that back to arc. I have a plan. Put that right. Okay, so that's all looking good. So we're going to now move on to putting our weights in. What I'm going to do first is come over here. One feature on this EFP, and I don't know if this is real world or not, if everything is in here correctly, folks, click set. And what that's going to do now, when I back and pull up the McDo, INIT, is this one? Okay, it's going to be saying recording. The weights are in there. There's our 57.9, which is what we have, 28.8, which is our CG0 fuel weight CG, and our 8.3, which is what's rounded up when you do 82, 84. So our numbers are correct. Now, we're going to go to the perf page. This is where things get real fun. Used to have a great site to go to, and I don't know what happened to it, but it's not available anymore. So I use TopCat. Unfortunately, it's on another program, on another computer, but I'm pulling up Archer on my rifle. Okay, I've got the weather in. Latest weather is still at 3, right down the runway. No significant here, and for the most part, the same in St. Petersburg. Alright, acres takeoff. Alright, so what this does is it's going to basically help us fill in. Now, one thing that's been bugging me, why can't I put in my reserve? Back to the INT, maybe I missed it. Reserve to be 3.3 entered, because I want to make sure I have enough fuel to go if we have to go missed approach at St. Petersburg over to our alternate, which is I changed this around, now I can't quickly find things. Oh, there it is. Echo Fox Juliet Oscar, and still have 1,571 kilos on the ground when I get there, so I have my 45 minutes. And I don't know if that's your MOPS or not. Okay, looks like I'm not doing it. Anyway, I don't know where to put that in. That's something I'm... Anyway, hello. For Chattis Roos, we appreciate you coming aboard. Okay, I'm just going to have to press on because I don't know where to go. All right, but what we're going to do here is we're going to fill in the perf page, and I am going to pull up my one site that I can still go to. black box 711s and get my thrust reduction. Oh, why is that? Because we had a FOD issue yesterday. It's still fresh on my mind. So I want to get that put in first. Going out of Echo Papa Whiskey Alpha. Okay, so transition here is 6500. We'll change that. There we go. Oh my goodness. Too much going on at once. Anyway, this site here gives you some information like thrust reductions, acceleration that you see on that bottom line, plus your engine failure numbers. So, again, we're going off runway 33, so 1370 across the board there. And our engine out acceleration. Okay, so we got that transition and thrust reductions. We're going to also check the chart. So hang on, let's move that browser around and go to this. I'm going to pull the chart. So okay, so transition is 6500. Okay. You can see that right up here at the top, 6500. Okay, so we'll just climb our 6000 as our max. And we're on the 5K, so here's our departure. So we'll see it, and runway 33. That is the chart. Wow. So you can kind of see how it is. All right, so 6,500 it is. All right, so. All right, so. Alright, so we've got our basic data in. The current conditions. It was hopes to put something in, folks. Oops. Incorrect. There we go. So 330 at 11, then 24. 17. Okay. So, for this, we are going to fly configuration 2. So, flaps 2. And slash. Okay, so I think we have everything set up here. And that foot sets up the big toes. What I'm gonna do here is just get it into now we're going to go and set up the middle panel, and then we'll be ready to begin our flight in a second. Since we're getting close. Getting my eight cards ready. Alright, okay, so pressing on, let's get the center panel set up. Switch to EPWA. Okay, and 1017. Flight director, arc at 20. Constraints on both sides. And altitude. 6,000, just in case ATC comes in. They're not. Push it all the way up to 37. Alright, so now folks, we are to the point where we're ready to push back. So basically, I'm going to call. Hang on a second. Better push back.
Router cockpit, please show me where you want to go.
How about we don't? I have to do that from inside the plane. So let me get up to that view. Let's try again.
Router cockpit, that looks please show so me where you want to go.
Okay, we're going to go to here. Click into there and click
around the cockpit. Toe is driving up.
Okay, so with the toe coming up, We're going to make sure everything is set up on the aircraft. So we'll go to services, fuel trucks removed. Time to close the door. Okay, and the door is closed and cargo loaders are removed. Okay, I'm going to come off external power now. So we're now on the APU. Let's come and take us that way, Warm the cabin a little bit for them. Cool the cockpit off a little. Alright. And turn the external power off. And
okay, all doors and hatches are closed. Ready to connect.
Now we're going to kick wing and beacon lights. Ready to push back, folks. And yeah, I'm running way late, and I do apologize. Got myself hung up in a couple spots, but hopefully we'll make it up in round two. So let's release the parking brake.
Starting pushback, and you may start engine.
We'll hold on the engines here for a second. Start engines now. Sorry for that, folks. Okay, basically move the boat selector over. And we click number 2 first. Okay, I did connect to VATSIM and disconnected. I don't know if I want to deal with ATC with all the troubles I've had today at the moment. So we're going to come alive, and I hate to say this, after we get out of the center area here. And the language barrier could be a lot for me to deal with right now. Got number 1 going.
Operations complete. That's parking brake.
So my apologies. We'll get on VATSIM here as quickly as we can.
Stand by.
Chattis rules, thanks for coming aboard. Folks, if you like what you've been seeing, I wish you would follow us, but I understand. But we do thank you for coming aboard and giving us a try, at least. Clicking follow, only thing it does is let you know when we're flying next and if you'd like to watch us or come along and fly with us. All right, so we got the engines running. So basically what's left here is, if you will, an after start checklist is turn the APU bleed to off. And then turn the APU master to off. And that'll start cooling it down and getting it ready. Now, before we taxi, we want to turn on the brake fan. Auto brake to max, and basically that's your reject takeoff setting in departure mode. Weather radar STS we can set to system. We're going to go system one today. And again, I can't do anything with PWS or any of these two switches. Let's see, moving on, spoilers, let's get those armed. See that white band. Flaps to get up here to verify. Oh, terrain radar came on this time. Idea. Yeah. And just making sure we're flaps to set. We are. And let's do a quick check of our control surfaces. What I'll do here is come down. Click the button, make sure we go left, so it centers, go right, and it centers. Yaw left, then right, and again, basically I'm wanting to make sure when I let go of my, I've got a OTAS here from Saitek, that it centers. Pull back on the elevator. Centering up nicely. And just kind of. Now one interesting thing, let me pull this up so you can kind of see. When you look at this, you'll see like this aileron BG, this one GB. Basically, what it's saying is what hydraulic system is powering this. The goal is to never have the incident that occurred in Sioux City back in the 80s. A DC-10 lost all hydraulics because the middle engine, if y'all are familiar with the DC-10, sits up on the tail, blew and sliced every hydraulic line coming out of it to the plane. The pilots and flight engineer were basically flying the plane with power and asymmetric power, meaning if they wanted to go left, they pulled back on the left engine. They had the two outer engines, the wing engines running, and that's how they were able to steer it and get some climb, some descent. The problem is they were coming in too fast, and they pulled the power back and stalled so quick. They got no flaps, and it stalled, crashed. We saw about 180 people survived that. So, folks, that was another one of those miracle flights that occurred out there. So, but anyway, we digress again. Let's get back on track. We've done the checks. Parking brake needs to come off. And, oops, let me hit my rudder trim and set my elevator. Trim. Up, three, I think it was. What I did, let me, okay, I was trying to first do the trim here, I forgot the wheels here, but anyway, I bring up the display unit here, here's your trim right here, so if you see up 0.3, just trim down till it says up 0.3, there you go, folks, turn that off, go. Now, we're ready to go. All right, folks, we're going to start our taxi. What we need is the lights. Okay, everything looks clear. So we're going to basically go straight, make this little button hook here, and come on down taxiway. All right, folks, here we go. What I'm using to align on my taxiways here on the center line is that post in between the two displays, nav display and PFD. This gray line right here is where I'm trying to set her on to. If not that gray mock, it looks like it'll be a little better. Anyway, we're going to taxi all the way down. Then we're going to, like I said, take that little button hook and then get on the main taxiway out to the end of runway 33. So, but anyway, if y'all see that I, especially any real-world pilots out there, anything that I'm doing wrong or saying wrong, executing wrong. One, I know I'm not a real Airbus pilot like I started the stream up with. I'm just a little old Piper, Cessna, Beech type pilot who hasn't flown since 1986. We need to get recurrent. But anyway, please feel free to correct me. Will not hurt my feelings. Just like seeing 737s from Southwest to Delta. Delta, maybe if they have them out of Paris or wherever else they come in. Southwest, don't miss it. Oh well, gotta love it. I don't like being on ATC overseas. taxi, one thing just came to my mind. You're going to find getting it to stop, just first get it out of the box, challenging. So what I had to do is, one, search the forums at X-Plane and Flight Factor to figure out why it's not stopping. And they told me to switch my toggle to, and I need to pull my phone up for this. So you want to set on my Saitek X52, you want to set your first half of the trigger button to a setting called Hold Brake Regular Effect. Then when you push it all the way in, hold trigger maximum. And then the pinky, which I forget in the fighter world what that's used for, you do the toggle brake max, which will set your parking brake. So just a tip there if you're interested in this aircraft. Now Tolis makes the A319 and A321. So, all right, so we're coming up here to the end of the runway. And what we're going to do is we're going to hold short. We got a couple of quick checks. We're going to, if we get lucky, we'll have a little bit of room. And then we're going to take the runway. Set the brake real quick. All right, so two things I want to make sure are running here. Let me set my sounds correctly for here going down. Is it 50? Yes. 50. Okay. Now, we need to do the test. That one streamer says basically what we're wanting to make sure is everything is set up for takeoff. So we do the TO test, config test by pushing the button. Everything should go green and normal, and it just did. And then we also want to see cabin ready. That means we're ready to go. PAX 1, PAX 2 will leave on. Landing lights will come on. Nose lights, we're going to also make sure the transponder goes to TARA. And we got the weather radar. Okay. And we're set to go. Now what I'm going to do over here, I just kind of zoom real quick. Again, you scroll up and you'll see where we are. Figured it would move anything. I guess it doesn't. Anyway, so we're set here. We're going to take off, fly the BAMP, this departure, out to BAMP zone, and then on course. Again, 6,000 is what we're set for. Whether or not we need it, that's debatable. So, set the center up. And weather-wise, radar here looks good. Here's where we're at. Let's see. You can see we got some rain up ahead towards St. Petersburg. All right. Lights on, strobes on. I said, I firmly believe if I've got 10,000, 11,000, 12,000 feet of runway, I'm going to use it all.
Approaching 3-3.
As much that I can.
On runway 3-3.
The throttle lever up to 50%. At 50%, we're going to basically then move it up to flex and roll down the runway. And again, our speeds, folks, so you all see 149 rotate, 150 V2. First 149, folks, is V1. Alright, so let's get that parking brake off. Switch our landing lights up. And get max brake fans on, and here we go. There's 50%. Brakes off. Again, like I said, I don't have the Airbus model where you have those notches. But I moved it up fairly quickly.
Rotate.
Hero.
highest is 10,000 feet. All right, folks, I hope you're enjoying the sketchy Leo. What's up there? How are you? Okay, so here we go around the good. Good to hear. Hopefully you're enjoying that day off. 6,000 chunk chunk. So need to be at or above 6,000 next. We're gonna chart up to 37,000. This is where Europe always plays with my mind. Because for some reason I always want to say 36. And even in the US it would be an odd number. I don't know why this is so hard on me to know. But anyway, we're airborne. We're headed to St. Petersburg. Let's go ahead and get the overlay in place. There we go. Okay, folks. We've had a couple of real-world pilots of A320s here. Not sure if they're still in here listening. To answer your question,
altimeter setting.
They went across my transition. Thank you for the reminder. We are running for Millennium Aviation. That's who we're actually flying for with the ACARS program. But this is who we're flying aircraft with. Of how we're set up right now. We're running on the gen. CAPU obviously is not running. Next up, we click all will be hydraulics. And again, y'all remember me talking about this. Let me show it. See how it says B, G, G, B, Y, and so forth. That, folks, is your hydraulic systems. Bring it up. Green, blue, yellow. So yellow, look at that page. Okay, so everyone that says why, well, you're going to have trouble with it. But you're backed up with the green and the blue system here. Same with the speed brakes and the trim. You're backed up with the green. So you get an idea of what systems. So when, say me working in a firehouse calls, you know, because we can get on a discrete channel with the pilot and say,
okay, we understand you have a hydraulic. What's going on? What do you have? What don't you have? If someone's up on the green, blue, yellow, they would then be able to look at a chart maybe and say that. I don't think we have that, but the pilot does. And he can say, well, I'm going to have this, 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 and this, and I may not this, 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 and this. So anyway, long and short, that's what that's neat to have. And that was a neat thing to, interesting to hear. Moving over next is the fuel. And we are out of balance. So let's go ahead, head up to the top panel real quick. All right, so we need to turn these off so this will burn down. All right, so first thing, turn the crossfeed valve on. That's the one in the middle. Reason being, when you shut these off, there is no fuel going to it. Now, this pump is feeding both engines. This tanks are feeding both engines right now. So that's what makes it come down faster. We just got to come down 70 kilos. I'd like to get us kind of balanced out. Get that here real quick. Nothing to worry about now in the airplane or in Europe. 18,000 is the transition from where I'm from in North America. Okay, so 30, almost there. Now, 2810 over here. First process. There we go. Turn these pumps on. They're showing on, and then we close the crossfit. So now. Now do you see, looking at the piping gives you an idea. Now if I'd have just shut those off to let this one do it, we'd have lost number one. No fuel. So you turn the crossfeed on, get how that now works. Okay. Alright, so let's push down here again. Let's click all again. APU. There shouldn't be anything going. It's not working. Air conditioning. We got 23 degrees Celsius to the cockpit, 25 to the aft. Those of you like me that live in the world of Fahrenheit, what does that mean? Well, 25 degrees Celsius is 77 degrees Fahrenheit. So, mid to low 70s in the cockpit. So it's 77 degrees throughout the cabin where the passengers are, and 74, 75, something like that in the helicopter. And you can see the rest. Good luck. I did it myself. Doors all closed. And arm. It says slide, so the slide's ready. You see our pressurization rate climb. This is the cockpit oxygen tanks. That means I have 1780 PSI in the tank. If we have to do an emergency descent, put our masks on, us here in the cockpit only, that's what we have. We want that green and we would like to have some air. Make sure we keep control of the plane. Next up, the wheels, they're up, the doors are closed. And I know that's not the correct term, but that works for me. Hydraulics again, all look good. And we're back to the engine. Do a quick status check, everything's normal. Clear, back to the. Alright, where are we in our climb? Coming up to 23,000. Auto throttle's on, AP's on, and we've got the dot next to 37,000. So, folks, we are climbing out as we should. Heading for St. Petersburg, Russia. Now, the next flight in this series, folks, that I've been doing around the world, Jason runs his around the world trip. Stand by.
Jason Bruns is one of my followers, and he set this up for us. For me, he asked me, hey, why don't you fly this? So, I'm flying. We're almost three quarters of the way through. Next flight up is a long, and that will be in the 767 from St. Petersburg to Tokyo. That's right, Tokyo, Japan. It's about a 9-hour flight. I haven't decided when I'm going to stream it yet. So, I'll let y'all know when that's coming. That's what I'm talking about, folks. See how it says TA only? It says it'll say that all the way. So I don't know what and how to clear that out. But anyway, when I fly that flight, I'll definitely be posting it and let y'all know in streams that it's coming. And then we're not going to the normal Tokyo Narita. We're going to Hannity, the original. So, looks kind of interesting. I thought, what the heck? 9,000 foot runways? Why not? So that's where we're going to head next with this series. Tomorrow, we're going to be back in Alaska. So, flying, fingers crossed, the new C90. We'll see. Been told to turn the engine anti-ice swarms on. Fire, either switch to the caravan or switch over to the default. So we'll find out. But that's what we have for the next couple of days, is this flight to St. Pete. Then we're going to do Flying Alaska Bush. That'll be a Nuvik Pass to Arctic Village, I believe it's called. What's it called? In a second. Tumble 5, and we are outside of Poland's airspace at this time. One thing we do need to do first, turn off the seatbelt signals. Check all of our lighting, turn the wing lights off too. Everything else looks good. And like I said, we are level at 37,000. Way to St. Peter's, Russia. Looking at the SIM Toolkit, we are estimating 51 minutes now. We are currently, let's see, currently 375 miles out. So what I'd like to do is let's go ahead and go into our arrival brief. And then we'll resume the music. So that way we all kind of know what we're looking at and what the charts are saying. Excuse me. Throat's all of a sudden picked up a fog. Navigraph have just been upsetting. That's airspace wise, folks. Okay. Oh my goodness. All right, so let's pull the charts up. Oh, I didn't want to do that. So we're coming in on the Colette One Whiskey. Basically, here we go. Call it One Whiskey. Which one is up here? Okay, this could be interesting. Let me fly something offline here. So what we've got here, folks, is we're going to go call it. There we got to be at or below 15,000 feet to LI-730. And there we got to be between flight level 15,150 and 6. And then LI-724, flight level 5,000. Direct DICO, which is the initial fix for our runway that we're going to be using. Okay, so let's pull back here. Let's get to the top. So we know what we have to do now. Maximum is 270. And below, man, we need 270 below 10,000. Wow. Okay, interesting. So there's going to be some interesting reads up here. Okay, now we're in Russian airspace. Russia went online, will switch us into some weird flight levels. And I don't have my chart up, and I'm not sure where it lasts that long. I'm going to have to get that up, especially coming out of St. Petersburg next time. But anyway, you see the frequencies across the top. Airport elevation 79 feet above sea level. And our HEPA. Transition levels vary. They don't give us one specific. So let me see. Let me try something here, folks. See if I can pull this up. Still bless you for having it. Anyway, what we're going to go with, we're going to split the middle, go 6,000. Let's see, what is the one I haven't brought up yet? Kavok, no significant weather, 1017, so it looks like 5,000, so we'll go with 5,000, and what I'm doing is, okay, it's kind of weird here, from 995.9 or less, 6,000. If less than 959.9, 7,000. Otherwise, 5,000. So it's really low. I guess that's what they want you out of. Okay, we're going to is, again, LI 724. That's a hard altitude of 5,000. Colette, we got to be below 150. So we'll set for that first. We make sure we at least hit 15,000 there and then get below. Okay. All right, so that takes care of that. Let's head over. I don't have the approach plate yet. Thought I did, but I didn't. Which one did I go with? Pretty sure I went with the Y. Let's do it this way. No, I can't. There's one button I missed from blowing the arrival approach so you can get a quick recap. That's okay. Just pull it up.
Got the Heil ALS 2.
happies on the left. That's what this diagram is telling us. This is our missed approach pictorial diagram. Okay, minimums for this approach. Okay, straight in landing, ILS 227 for the ceiling, RVR 550 meters. And then it tells you these out, what you lose. This right here, the 550, just in case the flight director or autopilot or HUD DA is not used, 750. So circle to land, this is what you got. So there's your approach, folks. Just giving you a quick rundown of it. Close that out. Let's slide this out and see what kind of trouble we're into right now. Top of descent is here. We're right here. Now I'm on the live map of Sim Toolkit. You can see this is the ATC that's alive in Europe. These green items are VATSIM traffic. I forget what's wrong. I don't even think POSCON's on here yet. No, it's not. But they would be yellow. Could be fun. But anyway, and it also gives you a nice little visual of what we're doing here approach-wise. Hey, oh, that's an alternate. Never mind. So here we are coming out of Warsaw right up into it. Okay, one last piece of information to get for y'all, and that's going to be our approach numbers. That one going over here to top cat again. Landing, TLR, landing. 10 right. Weather report just to make sure nothing's changed. Thank you.
sketchy Leo, you take your choice. We're getting ready to land in St. Petersburg. Welcome to join us in the world you guess. Your choice. We can always do Denver to St. Louis, Denver to, I don't know, places like Las Vegas, Aspen, Billings, Montana, Boise, Idaho. There's got to be some Stuttgart, isn't it, here? Wow, I did not know that airport was not in there. Isn't that like EDDS? Oh, that's disappointing. So, well, you could also fly Ramstein guitar up to, I don't know how long of a flight you're looking for. To get up here to St. Petersburg, that's a long one. That's going to be about 3, maybe 4 hour flight. But from there, you can go to Heathrow. Austria, Vienna, that's a couple of good airports there. Bonn's got a good one. Up to Denmark. That is wild. Shut an airport down. Well, I got a feeling we're going to find a seat. Like them flying over their house. They don't want to live with me then. I forget what the commercial's for, but they talk about nobody would want this place or something like that. And she opens the curtains, there's a 737 taking off. I'll take it. That's perfect for me. Utah's nearby, Munich's nearby, Zurich, Geneva. So they've got those to pick from too. That could be some spectacular scenery. Yeah. It's one. So that's what 2020 was all about, the scene. Doing is plugging in the Q&A chat.
917. So
I'm going to do is a neat little feature we have. I'm going to push this out so it's on the map. You can actually see the star folks. Basically, the way the Airbus descends, folks, the green dot here that's going up, that's basically because right here is where we'll catch up to the computer's projected descent angle. And once we cross that, we'll have the green ball right in between the yellow. Or so they say. All right, but folks, I do welcome you to the stream. I hope you enjoy the flight. We are on VATSIM. We are starting our descent into St. Petersburg. I've already done the checklist. We've started our descent. Altitude is set to 15,000, which is the initial fix of our arrival. QNH and all of the information has been plugged into our do. So we're ready for the arrival. We're just descending in. And we'll turn the seatbelt sign on passing 25,000 feet. As you can see, the green dots right in between the two yellow lines. And so, kind of let the music run a little bit here. As we come in now, we pull something up here. First off, let me let you see a nice view of our chariot into St. Petersburg. All right, let's continue. significant. St. Petersburg approach MAC Air 572 with you, descending through 11,000 to 5,000.
Air 057, Jupiter, Luka Bravich, good evening, Sets going 0710.
0710 for MAC Air 572.
Победа 207, первый подход, добрый вечер, опознан на полоса 10 левая, прямо на диком, снижайтесь, шон 5-0. 10
левая, прямо на диком, 5-0, победа 207.
MAC Air 572, we now have 0710.
MAC Air 0572, identified runway 10 left. Information India, descent flight level 50, clear direct DCOM.
Descent to flight level 50. We are set up for 10 right. Is that possible, or do we need to switch our FMC?
If it's possible, switch to 10 left.
Now you guys know why I don't fly on this much. MAC Air 572, Roger, we'll switch to 10 left. Thank you. Okay. Okay, folks, we've got it switched around because he can't change. That's okay. Now you're starting to see why me and VATSIM don't get along very well sometimes. Yes. All right, so. Set in. Altimeter is
72
clear, 10 left for the ILS approach.
2,500.
speed brakes out. Last time I flew this plane, folks, I forgot that I can pull those brakes back in. And they're armed. I thought I had max flaps out, and I did. Mac Air 572 has some runway.
Gear down.
Site.
Mac Air 057, runway 1-0 left, continue approach number 2.
Roger, continuing approach number 2, Mac Air 572.
Победа 207, снижайтесь 2500 футов, QNH 1017.
2500 футов, QNH 1017, Победа 207.
Это 3397, посадку совершили.
Юзер 397, собрать вправо, по-право 4.
Окей, флапс are full.
По-право 4, Юзер 397.
Hundred. 100.
50.
40.
30.
30.
20.
Long landing. Long landing. 9,000 feet
10.
Remaining.
Continuing after landing, landing lights are off, nose lights on taxi, flaps are zero, spoilers disarmed, transponder. Weather's off and APU, you need to get that going. Flap open. Get that started up here. Okay. Okay. Well, that's not good. And approach MAC Air 572 is in the gate. Thank you for the ATC. Have a great night. Okay, well, we're done. Said hello. We're going to go through the shutdown checklist. First thing of order, get the APU bleed on. Lights are off. Okay, so with the bleed on, throttle levels at idle, let's go ahead and turn the engines off. Okay, we'll turn the seatbelt and signs all off. Okay, lights are off. Turn the fuel pumps off next. wrong one. Is that a 5A? Oh, mode select, okay. Alright, and brake fan can go off. Gears down. Disconnect here in a second. All right, so let's head over now to our EFB. Set up our services, which is basically ground power request and chocks. Pack store first. Switch to stairs. Call and call. All right. And we'll get the cargo guys coming to it. Alright folks, there we go, we're in the box. Last thing we'll get afterwards, I'm going to go ahead and cancel with them. And we're going to shut that down. And we're going to file our PIREP, stop flight. Okay, file PIREP. Sure, the PIREP file before I close out. And today's date passed away. Waiting approval. Cool beans. Alright, we should be off. And we are. Okay, close that. Alright, what I want to do before we close out the sim, something I like to do. I'm going to rewind the tape. Before I do, and I'll get an error message if I don't. There we go. So what we'll do, come up here, click toggle replay. Do a little fast forwarding here. Queue up some appropriate grand finale music. Let's take a look at the approach. Part of my grumpiness with explain the sparsity of scenery. Oh, I just heard something here. Ooh, what happened? Here we go with a touchdown. Land on landing law. Wow, that was a pretty good landing. Huh. Okay, let's take her back out. That's it. RCC, thank you for the follow. We sure appreciate it. That I'm not familiar with St. Petersburg, I wouldn't know if there would be buildings on this side, but I would assume there would be. And I probably would assume wrong. Other than a long landing, that is not a bad landing, folks. At all. One more time. Right here, let's switch it. Let's see it happen. Guaranteed to always look like a good lady. But anyway, just to let everyone know, it's 178 feet landing along, 122 knots of touch damage. There's no complaints from this guy. So we'll just kind of stay with it as we wrap up the stream, folks. We really appreciate the opportunity. Hudson, RCC, I think, is that how you say that? Anyway, thank you for the follow a couple of minutes ago. Sure. Just helps me to know that, hey, might be doing something right here. So thank you very much for that call. Folks, tomorrow we're back up in Alaska. We're going to be flying, hopefully, the King Air from Inuvik Pass over to Chandler Lake. And if we get lucky, we'll head on down on another leg after that. So folks, from appreciate you all of the people that follow us. We hope to see you on the next flight, and God bless. Y'all have a great rest of the start of your week, and may your week be blessed. Have a great day.